Anna, my daughter. The year we spent on the road gave me time to think about things. Respect, responsibilities, duties. They all mean nothing compared to what's important. My family, you. I'm sorry, I only got it now. I'll go through this snow-covered graveyard with a sieve, if that's what it takes to find the cure. As for Artyom, he feels his guilt. He wants to atone. I'll just have to see that atonement doesn't cost him his life. The important part is that I'm back in Metro, and no mutant can stop me here. Radiation on the surface is different, though. Frankly, I thought I was buying a one-way ticket for myself going in.
You said you were close, but why do you need the Institute?
You are persistent. We're on a mission, but that's all I can tell.
But now, thanks to the green stuff given to us by Kirill, we both have a chance to achieve the goal and survive.
So, Private, Artyom left. I'd better get ready to set out too.
What about me, Colonel, sir?
You'll stay here. I'm putting you in charge of communications. I need someone to coordinate the operation. Can you handle the responsibility?
Yes, sir. I can.
Good. By the way, Private, how did you live here before the riots, when there was still enough green stuff to go around?
We did all right. But my dad was always out on a mission or a patrol.
So you barely saw him?
Oh, no. Dad did his best to come home earlier, especially on the holidays. We even spent the last New Year's together.
Colonel, sir. The maintenance guys asked to remind you to burn all the slime around the pumps once you reach them.
Uh-oh, I say the slime is done for. Colonel Kletnikov himself is taking up the flamethrower.
Don't jinx it. As for flamethrower, where is it?
Here you go, Colonel, sir. Mind you, it's quite heavy.
I know. Is it pressurized?
Should be, but I'd still check. The handle's on the side. Give it a pump or two if needed.
If you want something done, you have to do it yourself. All right, I'm off. Give slime some hell, too.
We'll do just that, sir.
We certainly will. Break a leg.
Break both!
Oh, thanks.
It's huge! Order to all groups. I just saw a fully grown worm, so watch out.
Alder, Red One here. Roger that.
Red Two, roger. Red Three, roger that, sir.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Red 3, I got a burst pipe here. Can't burn through a barricade. We're gonna need some explosives.
Red 3, you don't need explosives. Just find the valve that stops the water flow.
Roger that, Alder. Alder, Red 3 here. I found the valve and it's receiving its flame.
Good job, Red 3. Yes, pretty much. What's up with you?
My flamer won't hold the pressure. And I can't find a leak for the life of me.
Do you have any spare fuel? I didn't expect that shit to grow so thick here.
Of course I do, sir. Help yourself. Here.
Nice. Thank you.
I heard you helping the commanding officers.
do it, but the pumps must work. So I stay. Where am I supposed to get the O-rings? The slime just rots them and the pumps break down. And he just says he don't give a fuck. Can you imagine such an asshole? And I just go. So, are you telling me to steal them from another station?
You know as well as I do they don't make them no more. Or do you think I'll just shoot all my green stuff at once and go topside to get it?
You want results? You either get me the parts or go... Well, I told him to fuck himself. So he just turns all red and shouts, no green stuff for you this month. And I go, really? Then I do so for this month. Fix the pump yourself, asshole. So, that was it for that time.
just had maintenance on the line. They say the water's flowing again. They are sending a team to handle the rest. Mission complete.
Great. Thank you.
At ease, gentlemen. You did a great job there.
Thank you, Colonel, sir.
Frankly, we were on sweep-up duty after you, sir.
Ah, cut that. Sweep-up duty, sure. On behalf of OSCOM, I'm issuing an official commendation.
We serve OSCOM.
Great. We'll get out of those suits and go rest.
Certainly, sir.
Sir, take that suit off and put the flamer down, please. They have to be scrubbed for radiation. You'll also be getting a shot of green stuff at the checkpoint. I'll call them. You just took a week's worth of exposure, at least.
Good. Thank you. Right. Here.
Thank you, and goodbye, Colonel, sir.
Come aboard, Colonel, sir.
Thank you. Hey, guys, get aboard. We give you lift to Prospect.
Thank you, sir, but we're waiting for the transport from HQ. There's enough space for everyone.
Good luck, then. Let's go, Petrovich.
Yes, sir.
Your sleeve, please. We've got to give you the shot.
Here you go.
Roll your sleeve up, Petrovich. You get a shot, too.
No. Please, I'd rather use my own injector at home.
Be my guest, then.
Thank you. Don't lean on the doors, please. Next station is Krasny Prospekt.
Is your granddaughter getting worse?
No, thank God. Still, standard child's allowance of green stuff is not enough for her, even though we moved to the Prospekt. So I'm squirreling away whatever I can, just in case. It's not easy, but we survive, and that's what counts.
But enough about us. Tell me if you roasted that shit good.
That we did, Petrovich. That we did.
My friend, that is good to hear. Still, it will just grow even thicker next time. Like it always does. You see, the pumps are failing. It's because of that slime. And they've been working non-stop for 20 years.
And all this shit. The filters get clogged, the O-rings, they burst, the iron rusts.
Soon, the old counter-flooding system will give up the ghost.
And we'll have the rowboats here.
You'd make a good gondolier.
I can sing too. Hello.
Please, spare me. Your singing is an atrocity. Petrovich. Happy New Year.
Yeah, same to you. And don't forget, after the official ceremony, we'll be waiting for you and Kirill to drop by, as usual.
We'll be there.
Colonel, sir.
Colonel, sir, please proceed. The General is expecting you.
I don't need your excuses, Captain. If you take the initiative to do something, you must be ready to see the thing you started to the end. Dismissed.
Sir, yes, sir.
Oh, Slava. I've been waiting for you. Come on in. Make yourself comfy. There's been a new development here while you were out barbecuing. Take a look at these maps.
Background radiation?
Yes, Stalkers brought this in from the SATCOM center. And now, I want your people to go there and find the fresh ones. Detailing the whole country so that we know where to go. Take this under personal control and ensure complete secrecy, okay?
Go, Tolia? Cut to the chase. Are we preparing an evacuation?
Right. This is strictly between us, mind you. Yes. We can't delay any longer. We're out of green stuff. We'll have to resort to confiscations, so everything must stay under wraps for now.
Why the secrecy? It's good news. People would donate their stock voluntarily if we told them.
Not my decision, Slava. Still, sometimes it makes sense to save the good news for last.
I see. Thanks for telling me.
Remember, it's between us.
You know me. Well, Happy New Year!
Wait a second.
I better get home now.
As a hero of the war on slime and a lone father, you are hereby granted a New Year's present from the command. A one-month allowance for two.
Thanks.
I won't hold you any longer, unless... How about some tea?
You do know how to keep a man away from his family. How is Seryoga doing?
Full of himself, obviously. Just think about it. My son is a captain now. I never raised a finger for that. Can you believe that?
Of course I can. That's just typically you.
I believe he must achieve everything himself. It builds character. Oh, it definitely does. He used to be on the soft side. Like his mom. He really toughened up now.
You were always hard on him. Almost too hard. I could never be like that.
Actually, and I speak as someone who's been watching you too, I think you're doing amazingly well. He's growing up a real man! An OSCOM fighter.
Yes, he is a huge fan of all things OSCOM. We're like superheroes in his eyes. A bit chilling, actually.
But we are heroes. We're saving who we can, and it's all for our children's sake. What could be chilling in that?
He still doesn't understand many things, and idealizes us. Thinks we are knights without fear and beyond reproach, but real life is complicated. You must do certain things. And then look into his eyes thinking, would he understand if I told him about that? And that day will come.
Kirill is a real man. He will understand. A real hero's lover isn't someone flexing his muscles and wearing shiny armor. A hero is someone who does what needs to be done. He may get splashed with dirt, even blood sometimes, but he still does the thing because it is necessary. Understanding this makes a man a man.
Maybe. But it's quite close to the ends justify the means from there, though.
Oh, come on. Such a soppy load of crap. Oh, the ends justify the means. You can't say that. Those are bad, bad words. Shame on you. Our philosophy professor, Maria Ivanovna, told us that. But I say they do. How else would you achieve anything? You sacrifice something to get somewhere. Did this ever work differently?
Do they always?
All right, you got me there.
You're right. That's how you achieve things. But I always thought that it was a question of sincerity, if they do or not. Being sincere with yourself first and foremost.
That was deep, philosophical-like. I bet you took Maria Ivanovna's advanced course, too.
Well, I think I'll get going now.
Yes, Slava, I'm sorry I kept you here. Go. Go see your son. Give my regards to Kirill and a happy new year.
Same to you, Tolya.
I'll be working on my speech in the meantime. Hate making public addresses, but the occasion calls for it. Dear citizens of Krasny Prospect and our guests from other stations.
Colonel, sir.
Hello, Colonel, sir. A happy new year to you.
You filthy drunkard! Just look at yourself, you pig!
Oh, Tanya, I just...
So this is the new year.
Hello, sir. There's too many people in the way. You can't really go through.
Come on, Paul, we're gonna be late!
Come on! Just look! Look at what your son has to wear! Look at what I have to wear! There's no food at home! Do you understand that? I am in debt to everyone! I can't even look the neighbors in the eye! Do you even care about us? You're a disgrace! You drunk everything away!
We are celebrating here. Come join us, sir.
Carry on. I'm going home. Happy New Year.
Thank you, Colonel, sir. Give our regards to Kirill.
By the way, it's been a while since I last saw Sasha from the Third Company.
Happy New Year, Colonel Khlebnikov.
Same to you, Misha.
Look, one day we are going to go outside. We're not moles to live out our lives underground, you know.
At least hug you.
Not now. Look, there's people around.
Oh, come on.
Great disguise, Private. Though I must ask, where is your sitrep?
Oh, the mission of helping prepare the celebration is almost accomplished.
There's just one light bulb remaining, sir.
At ease, Private. I'll help you.
Happy New Year, Dad. I didn't think you'd make it in time. You were late for my birthday. And Mom's anniversary, too.
You see, I was just doing my best to make sure there were as few sad anniversaries in other families as possible.
Oh, I understand.
Good to hear that. Now, turn it on.
Mission accomplished.
Good job, Private.
Thank you. Oh, Dad, I have something for you. Here, Petrovich helped me fix it.
Oh, thank you, son. Speaking of Petrovich, as soon as the official celebration is over, all personnel are to wash their faces and arrive at Petrovich's place wearing dress uniform.
Yay! Arrive at Petrovich's, clean face and dress uniform. Roger that, Corona, sir. Wow, this tree is so beautiful.
Yes, listen.
Dear citizens of Krasny Prospekt, and our guests from other stations. Year 2034 is almost over. It wasn't an easy year, but all the hardship only served to make us close our ranks around our common goal. The well-being of everyone living down here in the tunnels. We are all looking forward to the coming year, expecting change for the better. And it is sure to arrive to our concerted effort as a community. On behalf of OSCOM leadership, I thank you all for your good work and wish you a happy new year. Happy 2035! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! Happy New Year!
Damn! This sucks! The damn generator is out again.
Kirill, Miller here. Comms check. Do you read me? Over.
Reading you loud and clear, Colonel. Over.
Kirill, I'm at the trading stores. Where's that passage to Sibirskaya?
It's downstairs. OSCOM HQ used to be there. They brought the green stuff they took from the people there.
I see. Confiscations. Found it! Thank you, Private.
Citizens, we urge you to remain calm. Voluntarily submit your stocks of Radio Protector to the authorities. Remember, our common duty is to stand together and ensure the common good of all the citizenry.
May I, General? Sir.
Not funny, Slava, and I'm not in the mood for jokes. What's up at Sibirskaya?
We're all done there, and this is what we got. It's not much.
This is bad. We're in the middle of a fallout spot, and we'll have to roast for 500 clicks at the very least. Your guys brought a bunch of maps, but there are no really safe areas on any of them. I had hopes for Lake Baikal, but...
Still looking for Baikal. The archive is trashed. As for the radiation, that's what the filters are for. Keeping the dust out.
Filters. All the carriages are so radioactive, no filters will help us without the green stuff. There will be children too. You have a son yourself, so you know children need more.
I know. Do we have enough?
Not for everyone at once. First we'll evacuate the core people, prepare clean rolling stock, and then bring everybody else out.
So you mean we're going to split people into sorts? The ones we save first, and then the rest
you know
the
what's
dregs?
At stake. Our children among all else. What's there to discuss? Didn't expect that from you, of all people. Think about Kirill. I, for one, thought about him. You two will be leaving with the first train. So don't fail me now. Just forget it all and take a break. Your people can handle the prospect by themselves.
All right.
I want another smoke. How about you?
Nah, I'll pass this time.
Well, suit yourself. It's been a while since I had smokes like this.
So, what did he say?
Well, he said they understand our predicament, and they value our contribution and cooperation a lot. And as soon as they get a hold of the new stock, we will be reimbursed fully and with interest, just as the paper says. He basically hinted that I had an official paper, signed and stamped, and that was the best I could have.
What was your answer?
What could it be? Yes, General, everything is as you say. Thank you for seeing me despite your
position. Hello, sir.
How's the situation, Sergeant?
Permission to address.
Granted.
An anonymous tip on excess stock. We can't ignore those, but he won't open the door.
I see. Let's go.
Hey, I feel like you like me a lot.
What are you touch, soldier boy?
Don't get excited.
I just remembered the New Year.
Come over here, sir!
Drink right over here. You remember?
Of course I do.
Open up, Petrovich!
Slava!
Thanks.
Come in.
Follow me. Mikhail Petrovich, you know why we are here. I suggest you donate your excess stock voluntarily, or there will be trouble.
Akint? You know I can't do that. It is for my granddaughter. I have been saving from my own allowance.
I can't do anything. We had a tip about your stock, and had to react to that. Commence the search. Check there.
But this is so unfair. I earned this, saved my wages.
I know, but we follow the rules.
I found the cash, sir. He does have some.
My cash.
Not too much here, though.
My granddaughter is sick. She needs that.
Sure, your granddaughter. I bet it's going to the market.
Colonel. Tell them, please! You know it's true!
Sir, this can't be all.
Enough! We're only confiscating the excess stock.
But sir, I will have to report everything.
Take this to HQ and report that stopping the search was my decision.
Yes, sir.
Look, I'm sorry. I know you didn't have a choice. Thanks for leaving me some.
I'm sorry too. You were right about choice, though. Nobody had it. I'll be going now. Don't mention it.
Thank you, Slava.
Enough is enough. Your quota wasn't conjured out of thin air. It was calculated properly, and you're short.
Hello, Colonel, sir. Glad to see you back. I'm sorry for the mess here, but the refugees just keep coming in. The dirty stations have it real tough.
Oskom, open up! Hello there, Private. I'm completely drained. Kirill? All right, Private. Tell me what's going on.
Nothing. I just want...
You don't want what?
To be a private! And I don't want to be an Oscom anymore!
Right. Please, elaborate on that.
I want to see Biroskaya. And I saw the soldiers taking green stuff from people. And one traitor want to give it to them. Started shouting. They beat him up and took all the green stuff anyway.
Well, this is just unacceptable. First thing tomorrow, I'm going to get their names.
You said Oscom protects people, but you just take their green stuff away. Why?
It's not easy. We're short on green stuff. That's why we must take from those who have lots of it and give to those who don't have enough. Or else the rich would just sit on their stock while the poor would all die. Could you call that fair?
Not at all. Of course I couldn't call that fair.
Right. Of course those who we take from aren't happy, but there's no other way, you see?
Yeah, if I had all my green stuff taken, I wouldn't be happy about that. But I understand now.
Good. Still, those soldiers were wrong. I'll make sure they are punished, and then they'll have to go and apologize.
Yes, make them. They must apologize.
Great. Speaking of green stuff, it's time we gave you a shot, so give me your arm.
All right.
Done.
Miller here. Do you read? Over.
I read you, Colonel. There's some static. Over.
I hear static too. I'm entering Sibirskaya. Was this where the last battle happened? Over.
Yes. I only know of it from Father's words. Right before the rioters started their last attack, we had to talk.
Dad, do you really have to go? We didn't rest at all.
The rioters are advancing. There's no time for rest.
Rioters? Tell me, Dad. If we, Oscom, are protecting people, why lie to them?
Wow. You've grown up, Private. And I'm none the wiser. So let's have a grown-up talk. Should we tell the truth? Of course. But life is a complex thing. In the hands of our enemies, truth may be dangerous. We must carefully choose who we can entrust with it and who we cannot. The command sees the whole picture and makes decisions. However unpleasant those decisions might be sometimes, they are still necessary. The command thinks about everyone, while the civilians only think about themselves. That is why the truth that might scare them must be kept secret for their own good. Do you understand that?
I do. But still, this is a scary way of thinking.
There are a lot of scary things in life. Yet, I brought you up well. You are strong and brave.
You can take it. All right, time to go. You get home and don't step out or let anyone in until I'm back. It's an order.
Yes, Colonel, sir.
Sergeant, walk him home.
Yes, sir. Let's go, Kirill.
All right. Good luck, Dad.
Good luck, son.
Sorry about that. I know you had no choice. Had I said nothing, they would have never believed they
fought. Water under the bridge. Neither I nor you had a choice in this, Petrovich. Good luck to you too. See you on the train.
Thank you.
Hello, Colonel, sir. Glad to see you back.
Don't stand around! Man the defenses!
Yes, sir!
I'll take the detonator. Give me cover.
Yes, sir. Attention! Covering fire for the Colonel. No sending ammo. Roger that!
Thank you.
in HQ. Klebnikov here.
HQ here.
One charge didn't work.
Damn. Fall back to Sibirskaya and stop them there. I've got no one else to rely on.
Roger that. Over and out.
Colonel, sir! They blew the airlock and are coming down from the surface!
It's either us or them!
We'll get them, sir! We'll get them, sir! We're
Successful. Pawns are all dealt with. ready for evacuation.
You fucker.
What do you mean? Already left.
What? What's going on?
We're covering evacuation.
Evacuation?
But you just killed everyone! Soldiers, civilians! Nobody left to evacuate!
Slava, there's only enough green stuff left to evacuate the leadership. Everyone else is doomed. Gas was used just to cut the agony short.
So you knew it! You knew it all along, you motherfucker!
Did I have a choice? What difference does it make now? I made a mistake leaving Mito. Petrov! Petrov! The fuckers left without us! Get Serioga on the line now!
What? Dead? Serioga? Son?
Now listen to me. There's an RPG in the gun cabinet. Get it and rush to the old crossroads. Blow the fuckers up there. Go!
So, what do we do now?
Whatever. I had enough. So long, Slava.
Uncle Tolia? Did he just kill himself? Why?
Don't look there.
I'm sorry I broke your order. There was a shooting at the station. Then it all went quiet, and you didn't come. I was worried, and I went looking for you.
Listen, I told you earlier. Who should be told the truth, and who should not? Forget it. It's not for us to decide. And if you're being fooled, it's never for your own good. That's why he's dead.
I understand.
Good. Now, let's go home, son.
I'm at the bunker entrance.
Roger that, Serrano. You'll be off the grid inside, so please, be careful.
I will, Kirill. Miller, over and out.
Pine, this is Older. Come in, over.
Older, this is Pine. Speak, over.
Private. I'm at the bunker's door. I'll be off the grid while I'm down there. Don't know how long. When is the next scheduled radio contact?
Midday sharp, Grano.
The battery?
Keeping it charged.
The door?
Locked. I'm eating the liver too. It's burning the slime, and I don't go to the dirty stations ever. Dad, fill out the whole cheat sheet for me. I'm reading off it now.
You do just that. Reading helps you remember. That's all, Pine. I'm going offline.
Roger that, Elder. Over and out.
Pine, come in. Over.
Pine here. Over.
I love you, son. A whole lot.
I love you too, Dad.
And I want you to eat that liver without fail. Over and out.
absolute secrecy and utmost importance. To recover a map of a region with tolerable levels of radioactive pollution from the Satellite Communication Center's archive. Circumstantial data suggests that special attention must be paid to map detailing, Lake Baikal. So far, our efforts have been consistently proving fruitless. But now, you must be successful, no matter the cost. I can't disclose the ultimate goal of this search at the moment, but I'll have you know that lives of all the Metro dwellers depend on it. This tape will self-destruct in 5 seconds. Good luck, gentlemen.
Personnel to evacuate the complex immediately. System will reboot now. All personnel are to evacuate the complex immediately. All personnel are to evacuate the complex immediately. Biological shielding compromised. Initiating reactor shutdown. All personnel are to evacuate the complex immediately. power failure. Engine to main power source. System reboot imminent. System reboot preparation is 20% complete. To evacuate the complex immediately. Reactor containment failure. Reserve power engaged. All personnel are to evacuate the complex immediately. Failing. engaged. Evacuate the complex immediately. continue. 40% complete. System reboot preparation needs. 60% complete. System will reboot now. All personnel are to evacuate the complex immediately. System reboot complete. Switching to main power source.
Thank you.
immediately.
Found it.
Kirill, I'm coming back. I just need a tiny bit of rest. I'm just so tired.
There you are, brother. You found the maps and took a break, I see. I need a breather, too. Boy, did these hunks of iron chafe. Gotta watch out not to stay for too long, though. Your son sent me here, told where to look. He's tough, your Kirill. Yes, I can see his effort. Children. It's always about them. I'm here because of my daughter. She's smart, strong, kind, beautiful. I can't even tell you how proud I am of her and how much I love her. I'm trying to be a father, but end up a colonel. It's as if by showing affection, I'd also show my vulnerability, not just to her. To her husband, too. At first, I even thought that boy was all right. But his obsession with truth started driving me mad. He kept risking his life while he had the love of the best woman in the world. Decent people want normal things. A thicker broth, a warm place to call home, and healthy children. But he wants truth. Let me glance at those maps. Boy, was I mad at him. But then I took a closer look at the world and re-examined my life up to that point somewhat. Especially when I heard your story. I saw my past self in you, friend. We both served the great lie because we both made ourselves believe it was necessary. And if not for him, I would have ended up like you did. But now, finally, my life has a real purpose for a change. All because I can finally look the truth in the eye. I think you understand. Thank you for the maps. Don't think it was all in vain. You saved us all. And Creel? I'll give him this watch and make sure he gets out of this hellhole. You have my word. Well, it's time. Farewell, Colonel Klipnikov. Rest easy. Stay with me. Hold on, son.